It was time for Elmo to get a little dirty. Getting ready to put in another in-ground garden here, kind of right next to our greenhouse. With a little fewer trees, this area gets more sun, so we're kind of anxious to give it a try and see if we can grow some stuff here. We're not going to do raised beds like we have in the middle of the yard because we don't want any extra height to shade the greenhouse. Even though the greenhouse is a total disaster right now, completely falling apart, we still may want to use it. So we don't want to put it in anything permanent that's going to shade the greenhouse. Our new garden is going to look a lot like this part of the yard, with deep compost and deep bark mulch walking paths between them. Again, these are not raised beds. The boards are just temporary. I'll be filling in those three spaces with compost and then laying in wood chips between them later. The boards are just propped up with bricks, cement blocks, and buckets of compost. Basically just anything I could find around here to hold them in place while I fill them. This garden will be a little different from the one over by the quail hutch. That one had piles of old straw bedding with plenty of goat and rabbit manure that had had a chance to compost in place over the course of a couple months. That in-ground garden was just laid in right on top of that layer. So this space won't be quite as deep of a compost system, but hopefully it'll be deep enough. I've got a tarp laid in below my wheelbarrow here, just to catch any of this spilled dirt. Thank you. As usual, we underestimated the amount of compost we would need, so we're back to pick up another load.
Thank you.
See, and I get to come see the new garden. You can take Sienna out there if you want.
She's too big. I'm gonna up like that. Yeah, okay. Great. She thinks I'm a long chair. See this?
So what all did we plant in these three beautiful new garden spaces?
Squash. These are all winter squash.
Are they going to spread out, or are they going to just stay contained?
They're going to spread all through here, so we probably won't even walk through here very well. It's just going to all fill in.
All right.
But I think it'll look nice once the summer goes on to have big bounds of green stuff over here in the corner and pretty colored squashes growing in the fall. Mm-hmm. So we've got some red curry, winter keeper squash, spaghetti squash, butternut squash, honey nut squash, some sugar pumpkins, a Cinderella pumpkin, and a gold nugget squash. I think that's it. Sure. Oh, and Rondonice. So it's like a round one.
Are you satisfied with the amount of garden space that you have now?
No.
We've practically got all the garden spaces we can have, don't we?
No. So in here, I'd like to put some more flowers. And I'd like to put some beans out here too, but I'm not sure I'll have enough space. We'll see. Make some beans and put it in the front that I haven't built yet. And mix it in with flowers. We'll see.
Still need more dirt for this area?
I need more dirt right here, and then I want to make a path. Probably either right there, maybe. Or right here might be better, actually. Probably right there, so that we come. That'll be fine. And then we come here. And another one to come right there, so I can go either way. Yeah, I need to be careful what I do on this end because the Amazon people will drive over it.
Yeah, we will get truck tire tread marks on the side.
Yeah, not for my truck. Elmo will not make tire tracks through my garden, will he?